It can take a major auto company years, in some cases,
a decade,
to design, engineer, and build a car from the ground up. There are thousands of hands working together to make it happen. So I thought, in the year 2020, is there a better way to make a car? Yeah, turns out there is, and it's called the Czinger 21C. The Czinger 21C is an American-made hypercar designed by AI and built using 3D printers. Is this foreshadowing the way the automotive industry is going to operate in the future? Or is it just a gimmick to sell cars? Why don't we find out? Thanks to Raycon for sponsoring this episode. I used to hate the city, the bumper to bumper chaos.
Scary.
But with 6 hours of playtime, these everyday E25 earbuds take me right out of the chaos and right into the front row of the jazz
Scary,
club.
Come on, we gotta shoot.
Ooh, that's old Tony tickling the ivories. They sound just as amazing as those other top audio brands, but they're half the price. Better yet,
Gary,
they offer a free 45-day return policy, so you can make sure you're getting the earbuds you want.
Jerry, we gotta shoot. What are you doing? He's at it again. He calls it a Raycon spot or something like that. You know, with all that bass and compact noise-isolating design, it's probably at a jazz club right now.
Tony is tickling away my ear holes.
He usually finishes by telling you to click the link in the description or go to buyraycon.com/bumper for 15% off. But who knows when that'll be.
Oh, Tony, don't tickle my ear holes so good. That should be illegal. Manufacturing a car has more or less been the same for the last 120 years. Manufacturing facilities are expensive and take up loads of space. For example, Volkswagen's flagship assembly plant in Wolfsburg, Germany is bigger than the entire district of Monte Carlo. And the methods have largely remained the same for manufacturing since manufacturing in the automotive industry existed. As technology grew, these processes got more refined and more efficient, but they still require a lot of bespoke machinery and a lot, I mean a whole lot, of space. But with the growth of refinement and efficiency, there comes a new thought process and brand new technologies, namely artificial intelligence and something called computational engineering. Kevin Czinger, CEO and founder of Czinger, is tapping artificial intelligence in a room full of 3D printers into the ring to make an all-American 1,250 horsepower, 270 mile per hour hypercar called the 21C, which stands for 21st century. And Czinger decided to completely reinvent the process of making a car and instead work from an inside out methodology, letting the engineering dictate the design of the car and then drape the body parts over the structure to make a sleek yet aggressive machine. And a byproduct of this is that Czinger AI eliminates a huge portion of the production process. First, we gotta get a little crash course on artificial intelligence, which consists of two main ideas, machine learning and decision making. Machine learning is essentially what it says on the label. It's a computer that learns things the same way people learn, by watching YouTube videos. Okay, also it learns through experience. And the more experience a machine has, the more data it has to interpret and analyze, thereby learning more information. And the second part is called decision making. Programmers will give the computer certain parameters to follow that are set out by the engineers and the creators of the car. And these are things like mounting points and size restriction, as well as strength properties. There are a ton of parameters that have to be factored in. So many, in fact, that when you build a car in the real world, it takes thousands of people spending thousands of hours and millions of dollars to do what a computer can do in a fraction of the time. You're basically defining the rules of the game and then pressing enter. Very simplified, but you get my point. Now, AI can even account for external factors, things like wind resistance and gravity and other natural phenomena. And a result of this is that artificial intelligence produces some crazy looking designs.
Nature, you know, obviously through trial and error and evolution, is very viciously competing for material and energy, which is why, you know, those structures have material where it's needed, no material where it isn't, and it looks like a leaf structure or, you know, the internal structure of a bone, marrow, other things, right? That you have, say, a major automotive company will have all of its own load cases, you know, road durability cases and other things. Say the machine is running those cases, selecting materials out of a database that have already been correlated, meaning physically tested against all of these different load cases, and is generating a structure. So then you have the most efficient structure for the case that's needed that uses the minimum amount of material, meaning, you know, you're reducing mass to the max and still meeting a performance set of requirements.
And this sort of super efficient design also comes into play with the normal non-structural parts of a car. Typical car contains about a mile of wiring to keep all of the pieces and parts connected and talking to each other. Now, a mile of wiring is going to take up a lot of space. And with this computational engineering and artificial intelligence finding the most efficient way to design a car, it's not out of the question that Czinger can incorporate all of the pathways for that wiring, not to mention all of the ducting for the things like the airflow and the AC vents. Normally, cuts and holes have to be made to accommodate those sorts of things, but with this method, they can incorporate it directly into the chassis of the car. This allows for huge portions of the assembly process to be handed off to software programs, not only to diagnose inefficiencies in the engineering process, but also build around those inefficiencies with the structural informative design of the car. Basically, AI is learning the shortest route to route that wire so that it's using the least amount of wire and taking up the least amount of space. It's just way smarter than a bunch of people. This means that a human being could never really manufacture the parts that are being designed by Czinger, which is the other component of how this hypercar gets built. That's additive manufacturing, better known as 3D printing. Now, this method directly contrasts to subtractive manufacturing process used in the majority of the automobile space. It eliminates any and all waste associated with manufacturing because the process only uses the necessary amount of material needed. A 3D printer doesn't print out extra material. Now, the 21C is primarily manufactured out of aluminum alloy, titanium, and carbon fiber. So how do you print out things like that? Well, Czinger uses a method of additive manufacturing that incorporates atomized powdered metals and a high-powered laser that essentially melts the individual grains of the material together and builds the product one layer at a time. Once the first layer of material is created, the printer pushes a new layer of atomized metal material across it, and the laser goes back to work, making the second layer of material. It's like building a cake. Okay, you put one layer on, then you friggin' put another layer on, then you put another layer on. 3D printing is the only viable method for this sort of manufacturing because of the fact that the materials are designed computationally. There's no sort of tooling out there that can make these designs with the strength and structural integrity that's required for them to work optimally. It's just not humanly possible, which is why Czinger doesn't use humans. In the Czinger method, we're sort of obsolete. They took our job! Czinger doubled down on the obsolescence of the current car creation process and developed something called the automated unit, or AU. And that uses a bespoke assembly method called vertical assembly. One AU is a 50-foot by 50-foot set of robotic arms that work in total harmony with each other to fully assemble a car. Some of the robots hold the chassis of the car up and rotate it as needed, while the other arms take all of the pieces and parts of the chassis and then assemble them. The 3D printed parts get incorporated into the AU and assembled with insanely low variance. We're talking about 4/1000th of an inch of precision. So there's no friggin' door gaps on this computer car. It's tight, baby. Now, the car as a whole takes about 3,000 hours to assemble, which, if you're wondering, that's 125 days. But the assembly of the structure of the 21C takes less than an hour. And the reason that Czinger can assemble the base of the car so quickly is because of all of these different bleeding edge technologies working together at the same time. Each robot can move at up to 5 miles per hour, which doesn't sound fast, but when you consider that the robotic arm can can do that while holding an entire car, that sounds just a bit more impressive. And also, each arm is operating within its own set of objectives, while taking into account the objectives of the other robotic arms. Each one of the AUs operate as an independent manufacturing cell. It's totally autonomous and needs little to no input from people or other processes. Other than actually getting the parts, both 3D printed and otherwise, there's little that needs to be done with the AU other than pressing go on the computer that runs the freaking thing. A side effect of this sort of assembly is that the robots can be very easily reprogrammed to accomplish a new task or make a new product. Unlike the dies and presses currently used to make parts in the current manufacturing process, Czinger's AU simply gets reprogrammed to incorporate the new pieces or new process into the vertical assembly, making the process essentially as simple as clicking a button. Again, this is a computer that's doing all the work for you. The robot and the AU itself are design agnostic, which allows for the assembly line to be changed in a matter of minutes rather than a matter of hours. There's no additional tooling that needs to be installed. This is why a conventional assembly line can cost $500 million or more. Czinger's vertical assembly method is estimated to only cost about $3 million. Imagine being able to save $497 million in expenses, not to mention 9 miles of space. What would you do with $497 million? Put a link in the comment.
I'd buy Nolan.
This closed loop of manufacturing makes the AU scalable, which is where this concept really starts to show its potential impact as a manufacturing process as a whole. So as it stands, one AU can theoretically pump out 10,000 21C vehicle structures each year, and it costs a small fraction of what a conventional assembly line costs. However, the AUs are limited by the amount of space that's available for them, obviously. And as it stands, one AU takes up 2,500 square feet. Now, if we scale that up to say 100,000 square foot warehouse, we're looking at 40 AUs all working at the same time, which in their current state could make 400,000 car structures a year. That's almost double the amount of Corollas made just last year. Now, Czinger's approach to making a car is small scale right now. They only plan to build 80 models, but that's okay though, because the net result of all these bleeding edge technologies colliding underneath one roof is arguably one of the most advanced and insane hypercars that has ever been built. As a car, this thing is just as bonkers as the methods used to make it. The Czinger team is constantly talking about how the SR71 Blackbird was a massive point of inspiration for this car, which, if you didn't know, is probably the most amazing plane ever built in the history of making planes. Even down to the front view of the car, it's meant to mimic the front view of the SR71 and be as slick as possible to cut through the air like a razor blade. And from the front, it basically looks just like three humps and a few vents, which is remarkably similar to the plane. This copycatting comes as no surprise, considering the plane can go over 2,000 miles an hour. Czinger is coming out with two versions of the 21C, the first of which is a track-only variant that's meant to just absolutely smash a bunch of track records. It's yet to be seen, but we'll see. And the second variant is going to have less downforce and be a road-legal car. Now, because it has less downforce, it gets super duper slippery and can achieve a top speed of 270 miles an hour from a 2.88 liter twin turbo V8 and two little batteries powering the front wheels. Not to mention, it can go 0 to 60 in 1.9 seconds. That's pretty quick. If computational engineering allows us to design cars that were otherwise impossible to design, and then 3D printing actually allows for those cars to be built, then cars are going to start getting crazy. And you can think of the 21C as the world's fastest proof of concept car. Thanks to everyone over at Czinger for letting us pick your brain. I got to speak to another CEO of a car company. That's two. Thanks to Jens, the chief commercial officer, for all your help. Thank you guys for watching B2B. Follow us on Instagram @donut@donutmedia. Follow me @JeremiahBurton. Till next week, bye for now.